favorite memory with Alex, besides all our adventures and escapades together, comes from back in fall of 2005 when we moved into TVC together. And if Harvey and Dickinson are over there, you guys will appreciate this story too. I don't know if you remember it, but you will now. We had just moved in, and Harvey and Puzz found some things that belonged to the previous tenants in a closet. And some of those things were a graduation gown, a baseball bat, sunglasses, and a mini keyboard piano thing that belonged to Kevin McCall. So Alex puts on the gown, takes the bat, and we decide to go out into the parking lot. We go out in the parking lot, and Alex, you know, assumes the batting position. Harvey gets on the mound with the keyboard, and he tosses this keyboard at Alex. And, you know, Alex swings at it, like full swing, right at this keyboard, makes great contact, and there's keys just go flying everywhere. And I wish I could describe to you Alex's face when he made contact. I mean, I have a video of it somewhere. I've been trying to spend hours just looking for it, but I can't find it. But hopefully I will at some point share with everyone. But I will never forget that face. I will never forget that day. And I will never forget that year spent in TVC. Because that's what laid the foundation to our great friendship. Not a day goes by that I don't think about you, Alex, and I know you're in a better place. Rest in peace.
Second, I need to get my story straight. My friends are in the bathroom getting higher than the Empire State. My lover, she is waiting for me just across the bar. My seat's been taken by some sunglasses asking about a scar. And I know I gave it to you months ago. I know you're trying to forget, but between the drinks and subtle things, the holes in my apologies, you know, I'm trying hard to take it back. So if by the time the bar closes and you feel like falling down, I'll carry you home tonight.
This is one of the videos going to Alex, and I want to let everybody know what it was like the first time I ever met him. We were at Roadside Grill in the bottom part where all the craziness happens, and it was the first time I've ever been up here before. And I got roped into playing a flip cup, of course, because we're all crazy people. And I messed up the first time, couldn't make it. And he was like, nah, this guy sucks, get him off, he sucks. And I was like, whoa, dude, give me one more shot. He's like, okay, all right, you got one more shot. Hit it the next time, right off the bat, first flip, high fives to him, hugs, and it was love at first sight. So that is my best memory of that fool. Miss you, buddy. Glad we can all get together today. I'll see you soon.
And you feel like falling down, I'll carry you home tonight.
One, two, three, four. It's me, Chris. Since it's Alex's story time, I figured I'd chime in and tell a little story about Alex's competitive nature, which I think we all know, and if you don't know, it's scary. It's very scary. In our apartment, quarters became kind of an addiction, and we started doing a competition of, you know, who could make the highest shot. We had this, like, yard glass, and, you know, sat there one night and just went at it until someone could make it. And one night, we were sitting there, and we had a penny. While we're playing quarters, we look down, there's a penny, and Alex is like, I'm gonna try and make it in an absolute vodka bottle. Penny inside that. And he tries once or twice, and it looks impossible, and finally someone says, you're never gonna make that. And everyone knows him, you know, telling him that he can't do something is an absolute challenge to the death. So for the next 45 minutes, Alex is in the background working on this penny and trying to bounce it inside this bottle. And we're playing quarters. We all kind of stop paying attention, you know, making jokes that it's his Moby Dick and it's going to be the end of him. And suddenly, out of nowhere, you hear ching, 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 ching. Sure enough, Alex has made the cup. And before anyone knows it, he's screaming, he's throwing, you know, trash cans and chairs across the room and just running around the apartment going nuts. So just wanted to share that story. It's a silly but a good view of how determined that guy was to do something when he had his mind on it, and I think we all, you know, could enjoy that one. All right, go back to having fun. It's like
one of my favorite memories of Alex is when I got my first tattoo in Blacksburg. As many of you know, Alex has no problem telling people how he felt or what opinions were on things. So as a needle was poking in my foot over 1,000 times, I heard cackling in the background and someone ever so delicately letting me know that I was being a puss for crying. Thanks, Alex. Love you, man. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I won't let